Dead and angels are desensitized, surrendering to submission, with eyes of restricted movement, denying access to the unisons of my sins, shaking me like thunderstorms of emotion, my life tainted with dents like a fierce monster, feasting on hearts of men drinking blood, with skulls at my feet and hands between legs, giving melodies of sin with lustful shadow orgasms, drinking honey like a stream of rain drops soaking. The clouds thicken, striking against my sins as the winds lash my back and whisper, like a tornado on horizons, ripping my soul, riding the debris with destruction everywhere, persistently whipping my passion in time. The angels cannot enter dreams to rid flesh and lust, or moans of wicked lips opening crimson gates, pleasuring the sweet honeyed hole of a sinful angel, where sin rules as unholy lust burns from inside, being humiliated in every respect by choking eroticism. The angels feel thorns of a tongue on their skin, flirting with sin, breaking the bind of a stabbed spine, turning to stone as eyes flash lost within sinful voices, with a burst of ecstasy which the soul penetrates, screaming the sweetest sin when being ravaged. The angels are a bunch of cowards like civilians, feeling unwelcome to speak like a criminal, thinking acts of physical desire and belligerence, as angels do not decide to spit on me with rejection, not allowing me to drink away bad memories. The angels do not belong within my circle, or inside their establishment of no punishment, with arcane rhythm where no beat remains hidden, where the impossible is sleeping next to me, as the truth rolls across my body of no protection. The angels cannot sew back together my shattered heart, when their wings have been stolen with a cut cord by my polluted steam coming out of my boiling lust, locked in a ground bedroom without sunlight glass. That point out sin exists on its own.